Yo, what is going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Tom Origins here, back again with another video. We are just chilling out today. Today is the 14th floor. And you know what that means. It means it's time to get this holiday started. Who's opened my bag? Who's opened that? Oh yeah, mum's up the boarding passes because I printed them off because I'm the IT one in the family. Which, if you know me as a friend, you probably know my IT skills are very limited to YouTube stuff only. Even then, not that good. But, that was very depressing. The bags are packed. This massive suitcase is mine. I packed it with my mum, folding all the stuff up. Can't wait. Helen is coming round any minute now. I'm gonna nip downstairs, whip up some lunch, because your boy is hungry. That line, by the way, I've not had any surgery. Please don't think that. I've been sat hunched in this chair and it just creates a line. I've got a weird posture, I'm trying to fix it. But it's like nearly 10 to 1 and I'm excited, but I don't go to the airport till like 3, so I don't know why I'm that excited right now. But I'm highly excited, I'm super hyped, I can't wait for this trip. It's gonna be fantastical. Can't wait to take you all along for the ride. Can't wait to go and have my first holiday of 2018. I've never had a year where I've not had a holiday. This late in the year, I think this has been the year where I've had this has been my latest holiday ever, because like last year we went in July to Benidorm and then we went to America after Benidorm with Todd. So I was like, that was like two holidays last year, and that's very lucky. I know a lot of people only get like one holiday a year, so you know, I was more than happy with that. However, it was just mental, because for like when you've got like a normal schedule and it breaks, it kind of feels funny, but you just got to adapt. So I've been working my backside off the last 4 weeks doing stuff in the gym to get myself personally confident for this holiday. Also, for the last 3 weeks, been working with these young children at this holiday camp. It's been super hard, but rewarding in the sense I've finally been able to save up a little bit of my own money, which is really nice. Also, I can't wait to go to Benidorm. I love it so much. It's like a second home. I've been there so many years now. But the reason I keep going back, which some people can't understand, but when you know somewhere and it's like your second home and you kind of like know your way around it, know the people, know the places to go, know the locations to hit up. Every time I've been to Benidorm, and I'll always say this, every single year I've been to Benidorm, I've done it different and there's been new situations. This is when I went a few years ago, met two guys called Joe and Joel, which are pretty cool. This is a picture of me and my mum and dad when I first went when I was little. It's like, it's crazy because people assume that just because you've been somewhere once, you should never go back, and I'm completely against that. Sure, going to new places is fantastic. However, every time I go to Benidorm, just because of the people and how vibrant it is and how amazing the whole atmosphere becomes, and plus now we're staying in a different place, not even on the caravan site anymore, the experiences have always been different. I've never gone to Benidorm and felt like I'm in the same rut of doing the same thing over and over again, because there's that many possibilities and there's so many quirky things over there that it's just unlimited possibilities every time you go. So I can't wait. I got some scuba stuff ready to go for some scuba diving. I've been ready to get in the sea, been ready to tan and chill and relax. And it's just been fantastic. I've worked my ass off all the way through September to get to here now, working through the first year of being in sixth form, which has been mad. I also sit in some exams and things like that. And I don't care about the results at this moment in time. I'm not going to stress myself out about it. It's just, you know, working in progress. Whatever happens with results, I'm happy. I tried my hardest that I could at the moment when I sat that exam. So that's as happy as I can be with my results. They're not my real results. I don't have to worry about them until I have to practice and revise, which I will do. But for now, let's just take all that school shit out of your mind. Forget your homework. Just get on some sun cream, get on some sunglasses, get in the sun and go exploring. And that's what I can't wait to do for 2 weeks with the people I love, my mum and dad and Helen. I love all three of them. They're so close to me. I couldn't be happier and I can't wait to go away with them. It's going to be so fantastic. I'm just going to go downstairs, get a little bite to eat before Helen pops around. When Helen pops around, I'm sure we'll film a little segment together, talk about what we're excited about and things like that. And I'll just be hyping it up until like, we're not even leaving till 3 o'clock and it's like 10 to 12. We're not leaving the house till 3. So, and I'm not even getting on the plane until like 4 or 5. So I don't know why I'm this hype right now, but I've just been hyping up all week, and now it's built up into like this big mountain, and I can't wait. It's gonna be phenomenal. So yeah, it's probably gonna double as like the first episode as well, because when we land in Benidorm, we're gonna be landing overnight, so there's not gonna be a lot going on. So this actually is gonna be the first video documented of the entire trip, because this is kind of day one, even though it starts in the UK. However, it'll finish in Benidorm, which I think is really cool. It'll be like a crossover. So I can't wait to do that. It's going to be fantastic. I'll see you guys in a minute. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the second Why Have We Gone Irish for the second part of the video. Yes, this is the first video in the Benidorm set. Wow, when I did that, my finger looked like it was 3D.
It is 3D.
No, it looked like it was going like out of the screen. It's doing like that really quick. Yay! Helen has arrived. She's not writing. She's actually
doing her nails, sorry. Precisely.
So yeah, she's
You're
doing
green. The... This is colour,
she has got green nail varnish. I fell over. I nearly injured myself. We are sorted and ready to go. It is time to nearly go downstairs. We're leaving at 2:30, which I'm excited about. And we're gonna see how nice Thompson Airline people? I don't know. The people who work for Thompson's Airline? I don't know what they're called. What are they called? The people who work for airlines? The crew? We're gonna see if the Thompson's crew are nice people. Because, had a little implication, because Mum's blonde, and therefore she's forgetful. Sorry, blonde people. Sorry, blonde people out there, but you're forgetful, okay? My mum's blonde. She's very forgetful. She's setting a bad example. I'll tell her off about it. Because I'm not forgetful. A lot of the time, but anyway, Mum forgot to pre-book the seats, meaning that Dad and Mum are completely separated. This is only flying out, coming home, thank God we're all together, which doesn't make any sense. But Mum and Dad are miles apart, going on this flight tonight, and I am behind Helen. Not next to Helen, behind her. So this is Helen in her seat, and then this is me. And that is how we'd be on the flight. And now that's bad because I'd just constantly be doing this. And she wouldn't like that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna say Helen here has flight anxiety, which she does, I think. She has flight anxiety, but only when she's on the aisle row, so it kind of is just like gonna be broadened. So she's just got flight anxiety. So she's got flight anxiety, and my dad, who is a legend at communication skills, where I get my communicating skills from, he is gonna have a chat with a nice air hostess woman and be like, excuse
me.
Gonna be a woman.
Could be a man.
I hope he's gay. But then if there's a woman or a man or whoever is serving us, we're gonna give our bags in and we're gonna be like, yeah, well, excuse me, this one over here. She doesn't like flying too often. She's a bit of a flight anxiety person. Could you possibly sort us out by just scooting me from behind her next to her, which would do us a big favour. So we're gonna see how nice of a company they are. If they're horrible, we're gonna roast the hell out of them. If they're amazing, we're gonna give them loads of credit and we'll shout them out in all my videos from the holiday stuff. But yeah, my suitcase is here. It's bigger than it looks in real life. Wait, no, that doesn't make sense. It's smaller on the video, but it's bigger in real life. Like, it's actually quite a hefty suitcase.
Massive.
It's a massive suitcase.
Why do you need that much?
Because Mum, but because Mum packed it. Mum, keep holding it on the wrong side of my face. Right, drop the phone. Wait, no, okay. I did it. Okay. So, the suitcase is gonna be all good, all good. My hand luggage. Alright, we're gonna get Helen's for reference. My hand luggage. Helen's hand luggage. This is the difference in size. My hand luggage is enormous. Helen's gone for a lot more of a resourceful take. I've just taken loads of GoPro stuff, which I'm sure I'm gonna get stopped through security, which is gonna be fun to go, ah, yeah, sorry about that, officer, but, you know, I'm a YouTuber, so I've kind of got all my wires with me. No, I don't know what I'm just gonna probably say something really polite, like, oh, no, it's okay, you're just doing your job. Yeah, it's just a few wires from my YouTube stuff. It's got, like, camera stuff in. So if you wanna have a look, you can do, if you wanna buy any of it for, like, YouTube or anything like that. But, yeah, I can't wait, I'm really excited, I'm super hyped. Yay! Pardon? I'll be like, go to Amazon and type in discount code Tom to get some discounts. But it's half an hour away, so I'm gonna wait for Helen to do her nails and I'm gonna carry all our stuff downstairs and then I'm gonna say goodbye to my little room, which I'm going to miss. No, I'm not. Yeah, I am a little bit. But it's gonna be amazing. I'm gonna go say hello to our new room. And the one thing I love about this video is that it starts in the UK and then by the end of it, we're gonna be in Benidorm and it's gonna be nighttime. So
we're gonna do a little click.
We're gonna do a little click and we'll be in Benidorm. But Yeah, that's gonna be crazy to do that and be in like the hotel and stuff of a night, and just it's gonna be great to know that tonight we're gonna be in a different country. That still blows my mind. The fact that in the morning you can be in one country and by night time you can be in a different country, and that is mental. So I can't wait to do that. We're gonna get to Benidorm like
two and a half hours away, 1 o'clock
or something in the morning.
What?
1 o'clock or something.
At
night? No, we don't. Do we really? I thought we get there in the morning. What the hell's going on? Alright, fair enough. So, we're gonna get there. Whatever time we get there, it's gonna be amazing. We're gonna have like a little look around the hotel and things like that. We're gonna sort everything out. And it's gonna be great. So, I can't wait to start this trip with me and Helen. And it's gonna be fantastic. And I'm so excited. And I can't wait. And I'm excited. And yay! No, I'm not. But what we're gonna do is gonna wait for Helen's nails to be ready and dried. And then she's gonna put some shiny stuff on them. I don't know what it's called. Shiny stuff! She's gonna put shiny stuff on it, and then we're gonna take everything downstairs and I'm gonna make Helen a secret cup of coffee that I've got. Because I got some luxurious ones in.
Oh, is that a surprise, that?
Yeah. So we can have a cup of coffee before we go in the taxi to our airport destination. Yay! I'm just gonna look at her with the sandwiches, she's going for it. An apple. Where'd you get the plates from?
I was just gonna say that.
Dad, where did you get your plate from? Dad, where did you get your plate from? Oh, they're down there. Ah, found the plates.
Escape room. This is mint. Hands free.
Look at that.
Pretty good. We have cheese.
Okay.
Look, that's what we got going on. And there's mum and dad over there. Yes. We're gonna enjoy this. I'm rated it. Oh, 10. Shut up, that's a game. Damn. That's it.
Yes. Right, I don't know. Okay. Cash or credit?
Oh.
Never.
What is it?
That actually looks funny. No, it's not. They smell like Palmer violets. They smell like Palmer violets. How are you doing? Thumbs up. Ah, your boy's got his passport. Let's have a look at this. Whoops, I dropped it! She told me I'm a player now, just can't catch the feels. But it's life still I got hand, it wasn't shit before the deals. For the buzz, before the money, when the world didn't know my name. Used to get shut down by women, why else would I be this way? Used to be a role model, now they tell me that I changed. How the hell am I supposed to find myself inside this place? Cause what I want is something that keeps me awake at night. I wanna feel your lips when I turn down the bedroom lights. I wanna show you something you ain't never seen. Give me one night, baby girl, just the dead is all I mean.
Stop the
Oh my god, that light was insane.
Yes.
We are in the extra leg room because this is how we do it. Oh, I've got you. Some kids just screamed, ah, oh, my willy.
Hello.
This is us, we are on the plane. We are on the plane to Benidorm, and this is going to be cool. There is Helen, and I am Tom, and there's someone with blue hair behind us. But we're right next to a massive window with a huge light. They should turn the light off. Look at that light. All that light coming through that window, they need to turn the light off.
It's the sun.
It's the what? Sorry, I've been in England for over a year, I don't know what the sun is.
They can't even name it.
Yeah, they can.
It's the sun.
The sun. I need to go to the toilet because I drank too much water and stuff.
So random.
But I do need to mention, I've not flown on a plane in over a year and my head feels funny. It's like, because I've normally flown about twice a year in the past and this is the first year where I've not, the takeoff, my entire head felt swollen. I don't know why, but I should be okay. And there's blue haired girl and other people. So yeah, fun flight. We all got off the plane safe. There's a sign for Benidorm now. As you're coming into Benidorm, there's a big fountain that has Benidorm written on it. There. Benidorm. There we go.
I should get a picture of that.
Oh, yeah. This is it. This is it. This is our home for the next 2 weeks. Three. Hang on. Dad, where's Mum? Yeah. Oh. Everything that kills me makes me feel alive.
Episode.